Asim Mangori murdered and dismembered a drunk woman in his home, which was above a kebab shop in Exeter, UK. He lured her by promising to give her booze, drugs and money. He was stalking her hours before the tragic, and this was captured on CCTV. Little is known about 24-year-old Asim Mangori, apart from the fact that he works in a shop and is a bisexual man. On the 1st of September 2020, Mangori can be seen in this CCTV footage following 32-year-old Lorraine Cox. She was out drinking with friends that day as she was going through a very difficult period in life. One of her friends had offered to drive her back home, seeing as it was quite late at night. However, Lorraine declined the offer and said she'll walk back home. He followed her from the city centre to the high street, which was about 1 mile. He then either built up the courage or saw a good opportunity to start a conversation with her. After some time of persuading her to go back to his, Lorraine agreed and they head back to Mangori's home. However, that was the last time anyone saw her alive. Her friends and family were getting extremely worried, and after not hearing from her for another 2 days, they reported Lorraine missing on the 3rd of September. The police then arrested Mangori. However, initially, he gave them a fake name and called himself Christopher Mayer, and he was apparently a 22-year-old man. The police failed to confirm his identity, and eventually they realised he was lying, and he was in fact 24-year-old Asim Mangori. He was therefore subsequently arrested. Just a week later, a murder probe was launched. After further investigation, they were able to trace the man who Lorraine was last seen with before her death. The police was working hard to locate Lorraine's body, and they found parts of her body had been disposed in an alleyway next to the shop and in the woodlands. Her body was cut into 7 pieces using a sharp knife. During the dismemberment, it was said her arms and leg were neatly and cleanly removed at the joints. The forensic report showed Lorraine's torso had been mutilated by a strip of skin being removed from the lower back and bottom. Lorraine's forehead and tattoos were also sliced. There were no signs of injury or natural disease. When they found her body, it was heavily decomposed and impossible to confirm whether she had been asphyxiated or suffocated. However, they did find Lorraine's t-shirt in her mouth. After murdering her, Mangori logged into Lorraine's Facebook and made a status, telling people she had moved to Plymouth. However, her friends were quick to spot that it was not Lorraine and someone had stole her phone, pretending to be her. Lorraine was type 1 diabetic, so she needed daily insulin injection. However, she left her medical kit at home. Therefore, family suspected that if she was still alive, she was in a very dangerous situation because she needed her medical kit to survive. During Mangori's trial, he said the two had sex in the alleyway in which he recorded on his phone. Following that, they went to his room and smoked some unidentified drugs. He later went into a panic because Lorraine suddenly fell on the floor and then died after using the drugs. However, this was contrary to the toxicology and pathology report, as they found no evidence of any drugs in Lorraine's body or that she had died from complications of type 1 diabetes. Mangori's claim was dismissed because they found he had made videos of himself vaping and listening to music next to Lorraine's lifeless body, seemingly having a good time. It was reported that Mangori had hid Lorraine's body in his bedroom, but with time, the body was decomposing and the stench was getting stronger and more unbearable, therefore he needed to get rid of her. He dismembered her into 7 pieces, individually wrapped her body parts in 4 layers of bin bags, with the exception of her lower left leg and knee. In the days following her death, Mangori went to the shops to purchase equipment needed to dispose her body. In order to conceal the evidence, he tried to get rid of Lorraine's belongings. CCTV caught him throwing Lorraine's SIM card down a drain in an alleyway just outside of the kebab shop. Mangori from Stoke-on-Trent was found guilty of the murder of Lorraine Cox and was sentenced to at least 20 years in jail. This is an incredibly sad case and has some similarity with the case of Grace Mullane. She was a young girl who travelled to New Zealand, who unfortunately met up with a man from Tinder and he murdered her on their first date. If you're interested in that case, then please do click here. Thank you so much for watching. Please do support our channel by giving us a like, comment down below with your thoughts, share our videos to people who may find our content interesting. Stay alert and stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.